Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and our top stories. We are tracking for you on Monday, the 12th of August. Protest erupts in India against attacks on Hindus in Bangladesh. POGB locals in dark despite Hansal hydropower project demand from its troops. And Taliban tightens grip fears into rule, says Human Rights Watch. And now for all the details. Hindus in India on Monday held protest against the alleged atrocities against minorities in Bangladesh after Sheikh Hasina resigned and fled from the country. According to news agency Reuters, at least 45 people were injured as homes, businesses and temples of Hindus in Muslim-majority Bangladesh were targeted. Protesters in India's Coimbatore marched along the streets raising slogans against the persecution of Hindus, including children and women. An effigy representing Bangladeshi extremists was also burned down in northern India's Varanasi city. The new interim government has, however, said that it is working to resolve the attacks on Hindus and other religious minorities. Hindus, who make up about 8% of Bangladesh population of 170 million, have traditionally supported Hasina's Awami League party, which sparked people's anger after violent clashes between anti-quota protesters and security forces last month.
आज यहाँ पर बांग्लादेश में जो जिहादी कट्टरपंथी बांग्लादेश को जला रहे हैं उसके विरोध में प्रदर्शन किया गया है और सभी मानवाधिकार संगठनों से हम लोग पूछते हैं कि जो महिलाओं और बच्चों पर जो अत्याचार हो रहा है उसके लिए वो कहाँ है, ये किस तरह का उनका विरोध प्रदर्शन है, चाहे वो छात्र एकता के नाम पर हो रहा हो चाहे धर्म के नाम पर हो रहा हो, जहाँ पर महिलाओं और बच्चों को टारगेट किया जा रहा है।
Meanwhile, Sajeev Wazir, the son of Sheikh Hasina, refuted reports surfacing on social media regarding her resignation. Wazir, in a post on X, strongly denied the authenticity of the statement, asserting that the report attributed to his mother published in a newspaper is completely false and fabricated. Hasina is currently taking shelter in India with her sister. The anti-terror operation in the forest area of Anantnag district of India's Jammu and Kashmir entered the third day on Monday as security forces widened the search area to flush out terrorists. Earlier, two soldiers and one civilian were killed in the exchange of fire with terrorists on Saturday, following which a massive manhunt was launched. An official said that it can be speculated that it was a group of 3 to 4 terrorists. The region has witnessed multiple attacks since 9th of June when terrorists opened fire on a bus carrying Hindu pilgrims, killing at least 9 and injuring several others.
इस ऑपरेशन के दौरान जो है सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस के जो दो अहलेकारों को जो थे वो शदीद तौर से जख्मी हो गए थे. बाद में दे अटेंड मार्टिरडम आल्सो. एक अहलकार और इंजर्ड था जो कि अभी स्टेबल है और इसी वहां पर एक और जो कि तफ्तीश का मौजू भी है, वहां पे कुछ और लोग थे जो कि इस गोलियों के तबादले में उसकी जद में आए, जिसमें एक जो सिविलियन था वो भी शदीद तौर पे जख्मी होके ही सकम टू हिज इंजरीज.
And Team India concluded its Paris Olympics 2024 feat with 6 medals, which includes 1 silver and 5 bronze. The country sent a total of 117 contingents to compete in different events at a marquee event. India, however, witnessed more heartbreaks than joy as it missed out on 6 potential medals by a close margin and the disqualification of wrestler Vinesh Fogart ahead of a historic final for silver medal added to the woes. Double bronze medal winning shooter Manu Bhakar and bronze winning Indian men's hockey player P.R. Srijesh were India's flag bearers for the closing ceremony of the Paris Olympics on Sunday. India finished 71st on the medal tally.
It's a great honor, last tournament, and got this opportunity to carry the flag in the closing ceremony. So fantastic.
I feel great, and carrying the flag in the closing ceremony would be an honor of a lifetime, and I'll always cherish this memory.
Meanwhile, Pakistan's Arshad Nadeem, who secured lone medal gold in the men's javelin, returned to a heroic welcome back home. He knocked defending champion Neeraj Chopra of arch rival India into second place. Nadeem's triumph in Paris is all the more impressive for a man born and raised in a mud brick house in an impoverished corner of rural Pakistan. He trained in local wheat fields with homemade javelins, iron rods and canisters filled with cement. His district barely had reliable water and electricity supplies, let alone proper sports facilities for him to train. Pakistan mostly channels its limited funding for sports into team games such as cricket and hockey.
अजय बिल्कुल मैं भी बेसिकली क्रिकेटर था मैंने ऑल पंजाब क्रिकेट खेली बड़ी अच्छी गेम थी और जैसे कि आपको पता है कि क्रिकेट में आ गया ना बड़ा मुश्किल था तो और मुश्किल होता भी है तो इसलिए मैंने क्रिकेट छोड़ी और एथलेटिक्स में आया कि क्रिकेट के अलावा जो गेम्स हैं हमारी उसको इंशाल्लाह प्रमोट करूं और मैंने मेहनत की है मेरे जो कोचेज़ हैं उन्होंने मेरी मेहनत करवाई तो आज अल्लाह का शुक्र है कि मैंने क्रिकेट छोड़ी और आज मैंने साबित किया है कि क्रिकेट के अलावा भी हमारी गेम्स हैं उनको प्रमोट किया जाए उस पर वर्क किया जाए तो हम पूरी दुनिया में पाकिस्तान का नाम रोशन कर सकते
मूविंग ऑन Residents of Hanzail in Gilgit-Baltistan are facing a double whammy. Despite living near a hydropower project, they are grappling with severe power cuts. To add insult to injury, the promised jobs for locals have also not materialized. A report.
Residents of Hanzail in Pakistan-occupied Gilgit-Baltistan are up in arms over severe power outages, despite living in the shadow of the Hanzail hydropower project. While the project has been approved and funds allocated, work remains stalled. Instead, authorities are focusing on a new 40 megawatts project without completing the already approved 20 megawatts initiative. A local said adding to their woes is the unfulfilled promise of jobs. While the government had assured employment opportunities for Hanzail residents, most positions have been filled by outsiders.
Approved ho ke 20 megawatt to ho gaya. टेंडर भी हो गया इन्होंने एडवांस पैसे भी लिए हैं मोबिलाइजेशन एडवांस भी लिए हैं भाई आप काम शुरू करें भाई 20 मेगावाट का 40 मेगावाट आप बाद में बनाएं हमें चाहिए 100 मेगावाट बनाए 200 मेगावाट बनाए रिवर पे
और हमारे जवान तबका जो है उनके साथ ये एग्रीमेंट हुआ था कि बेसिक जो चीज़ें हैं कि नौकरियाँ देंगे आपको जो मुलाजमतें हैं और 1 से 11 स्केल तक और पहले जो है यहाँ के हिंद लोकल जो लोग हैं उनको दी जाएंगी बाद में जब ये पीढ़ी चेंज हो गए तब से हमारे साथ कोई इनका वो राबिता नहीं रहा है और जो लोग यहाँ पे लगे हुए हैं वो सारे बाहर के हैं हिंदल का कोई नहीं है 1 से 2 बंदे उस वक्त जब पहले एग्रीमेंट हुआ था 2 से 3 बंदे हमारे लगे थे उसके बाद अभी तक कोई नौकरियां हमें नहीं दी गई है
The residents want protests if the situation does not improve. They demanded that the government and officials honor their commitments and start addressing the pressing issues of electricity shortage and local employment.
Moving on, the Human Rights Watch has said in a report that the Taliban has created the world's most serious women's rights crisis since seizing power in Afghanistan 3 years ago. Afghanistan is also experiencing one of the world's worst humanitarian crises, with aid severely underfunded, thousands of Afghans forced back into Afghanistan from Pakistan, and thousands of others expecting to emigrate to Western countries still waiting. Under the Taliban, Afghanistan is the only country where girls are banned from education beyond the 6th grade. The Taliban has also violated women's rights to freedom of movement, banned them from many forms of employment, dismantled protections for women and girls experiencing gender-based violence, created barriers to them accessing healthcare, and barred them from even visiting parks. Taliban restrictions on women and girls have impeded access to healthcare, jeopardizing their right to health. Taliban claims that they are following everything respective to the Sharia law. And Maldives President Mohamed Muizu has reaffirmed his commitment to strengthening historic ties with India, calling the country one of the closest allies and invaluable partners. The comments came during the visit of India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar, who called on the President over the weekend. During the visit, Jaishankar signed MOUs on capacity building and inaugurated 6 high-impact community development projects, including handover of water supply and sewerage facilities on 28 islands in the Maldives, a project funded through Indian government's line of credit facility. Notably, this was the first high-level trip to Maldives since President Muizu, who is a widely considered a pro-China leader, assumed office last November. India's relationship with the Maldives had come under severe strain as Muizu, within hours of his oath, demanded the withdrawal of Indian military personnel. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.